It's Wednesday, Klaus here. It's time for another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial.
Hello, Klaus here. It's Wednesday yet again, and time for another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial. If you did see my tutorial from Monday, all about doing this Indiana Jones inspired map effect, also done in my documentary Wunderlich. If you haven't seen Wunderlich, check out the link down in the description below. There is a link and a pretty nice discount for my documentary. Anyway, with that out of the way, I thought maybe you don't want to go into Fusion and do this effect. Can I do something similar without going into Fusion? And of course you can. So in this video, I'll show you just that. Okay, so first up, I'm going to take the same map as I had, and let's extend this to, let's say, 6 seconds or something like that. Here we go. Here we have our map. And you know, now I want to go into my effects library, go into the generators, and I'm just going to drag in a solid color, and I'm going to make this fit my clip. Then I am simply going to change the color by going up to the inspector, and in this case we'll do it a reddish color, something like that. Then I'm going to right click, and I'm going to do a new compound clip. We're going to call this line. I'm just going to push create, and then I'm going to take the opacity of that and drag that quite a bit down. So for the part we need to do now, we need to go into the color tab, mainly because if we do want to do some kind of masking, we kind of have to do that inside of the color as of right now in DaVinci Resolve at least. So we'll go into the color, select our compound clip, then I'll go into my mask. In this case, I'm just going to use a curve mask, and I'm just going to zoom in a bit. And you do that, by the way, if you have a mouse with a scroll wheel or middle click button, you can zoom in like that and or hold that and drag it around like this. So what I need to do is I want to go from Denmark, and I'm going to do a square, something like that. And now I need to do the animation where the line moves. And then I'll need to go over to the tracker for doing that. And in here, I'm going to set in a keyframe. But before I do that, I'm going to push in the frame mode and push a keyframe. And now we're just going to go through our 5 seconds. And I want to do the animation here. So I'm quite simply just going to do this little animation here. So of course, if you wanted to start bending or doing something else than straight lines, you could just put in another mask and make the other direction work. But for this thing, I'm going all the way down here in a straight line because we are traveling with a train right down here. Okay. So now we have the animation itself, as you see right here. If we go back to the edit, nothing is happening. And why is that? Simply because we need to add in a alpha out. In this case, we right click and we have this menu, and we're just going to put an alpha out. Then we're going to drag and connect this like so, and now we have line moving. So here we have the effect, and right now it's not very visible, but of course that's because of our composite mode and the opacity. So we're going to bump this up until we can go to 200, or we can make it a little transparent, something like that. So here we have a line going all the way down to Germany by train. Something like that. Of course, we could make this a little more interesting if we highlight both our clips, right click, and we just do a new compound clip, like so. So now we're going to take our animation and the map, and we're going to zoom in a bit. We're going to position it again right here. I'm going to put in two keyframes in the zoom and in the position, and I'm going to go into the end of the clip. And when we are at the end, you know, we want it to be around here. So now we have this lovely moving effect right here. So if we want to, I don't know, make this a little more fun to watch as well, we might as well go into our open effects, and we're just going to write film here. And we're just going to take our film damage and put that on top. Then we have this old school effect right here. Something like that. Okay, that is another way of doing this Indiana Jones inspired travel map effect. This time done inside of the edit tab, the color tab, and staying the hell away from Fusion because we don't want to do it inside of that. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's another video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.